perhaps you forget about all the shopping you haven't yet done. Forget about the list of things to do, the baking you have to do, and the packages to wrap. Forget about everything, except right here and right now, as we tell the old, old tale of Christmas. A prophecy about a coming Messiah, an angel visit to a young girl, a sleepy group of sheep herders on a hillside, an angel choir, and a manger box stuffed with hay. President Calvin Coolidge said Christmas is not a time nor a season, but a state of mind. To cherish peace and goodwill, to be plenteous in mercy, is to have the real spirit of Christmas. Garrison Keillor wrote, "A lovely thing about Christmas is that it's compulsory, like a storm, and we all go through it together." Christmas is love in action. Every time we love, every time we give, it's Christmas. Christmas is the day that holds all time together. But Christmas is not an external event at all. It's a piece of home that one carries in the heart. Christmas can feel like a lot of work, particularly for mothers. But when you look back on all the Christmases in your life, you'll find you've created family traditions and lasting memories. Those memories, good and bad, are really what help keep a family together over the long haul. Those who have been blessed with happy childhoods may enjoy going home, even after becoming adults. We like to be home with the people we love. Sometimes we even long for it. For others, going home is a painful disappointment, but our longing is the same. We want to feel that we have truly and safely arrived at home. There's no place like home for the holidays.
Thank you.
just a minute and journey there with me. The house is warm, smells like Christmas cookies baking in the oven. A fire slowly burns in the fireplace, and you sit for a moment, just a moment, to read a card from a friend. Such a happy time Christmas is. The kids have decorated the tree with handmade ornaments, far prettier than any from a store. And they've placed them ever so carefully on the limbs of the tree. On the radio, you will hear some melodies, the ones you grew up with. The music takes you back to so many joyful times in your life, times of childhood, times of love, times forever remembered. The children huddle around and marvel at the colored lights. They try to guess the content of each package shaken. They sit and dream of the special morning to come. The song of my grown-up Christmas list is a song that recalls one's transformation from childhood to adulthood. Its lyrics reflect on the things that were once important at Christmas time. Santa, presents under the tree, and the illusion and magic that are an integral part of Christmas for a child. The composers wrote, "I'm not a child, but my heart still can dream."
Thank you. This is my grown-up Christmas.
More than 700 years before the first Christmas, the prophet wrote, "The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of the shadow of death, upon them a light has shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs with his arm and carry them in his bosom and gently lead those who are with young. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light."
Thank you.
was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." But when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and he shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Then Mary said, "Behold, the maidservant of the Lord, let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. Mary was betrothed to Joseph, and before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. The angel of the Lord then appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take you Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit, and she shall bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus." And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. So all went to be registered, every one to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. What kind of man Joseph was, to stand by his wife under those circumstances and be a father to her son, not knowing what was to come. Miraculous. One humble young woman and one honorable man, trusting God's plan.
Space. Thank you.
and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
Oh,
The shepherds who were witness to this recital of heaven's music were soon to meet the composer, the creator of songs and stars and wonders and worlds. They would find him wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger. And although they could not begin to comprehend all they had seen and heard, the shepherds rejoiced. And Mary, the mother God chose for his only son, looking back on all the miraculous moments since the angel first appeared to her, pondered all of these things in her heart. Has been born king of the Jews. We saw his star, and it rose, and have come to worship him. When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. In Bethlehem, in Judea, they replied, for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel. After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother, Mary, and bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you.
iron chains wrapped around and around, tinsel lights and the smell of fresh pine, presents nestled under the tree. It's Christmas! Cookies, candy, and treats for all. The smell of homemade pumpkin pie, Mom's famous recipe, Dad's favorite song. It's Christmas. Gather up the kids and caroling we go, visiting friends and family, singing all the tunes, perhaps a bit off-key, but still, it's Christmas. No other time quite like this. No other time has the memories and traditions. Christmas carols, Christmas cards, ribbons, bows, toys and laughter, children and joy. The morning comes all too soon. Will I get everything done? Get the turkey in the oven. Wait, Dad. Gather at the tree. Where's my coffee? Gifts for everyone on my list. But, some go without. And some are forgotten. Some are away. Some are unknown. The celebration goes on without them. What can be done? What should be done? What must be done? So the celebration is truly for all. Gifts for all, not just at home. Gifts for all means everyone. How can we reach past our Christmas, our own Christmas, with the spirit of Christmas love?
Just a little kid.
everywhere they go, their whole lives long, let them know love. There's something about the holidays that makes the planet communal. Even people who don't celebrate Christmas can't help but be caught up in the collective spirit of their neighbors as twinkling lights dot the landscape and carols fill the air. It's an inspiring time of year. Christmas gives us the opportunity to pause and reflect on the important things around us, a time for our own grown-up Christmas list, the time that would heal all hearts and everyone would have a friend, and right would always win till each child is fed, till all men are free, till the world becomes a family. Light this world with your love, and God bless us, everyone.
Gives them an opportunity to make a difference by volunteering. As they prove they're trustworthy in their volunteer jobs, it gives them more responsibility, and it trains them for leadership positions. So after a few months, they've gone from being a guest who had no home or shelter to being people who have, in a sense, built a resume. They've learned to show that they are responsible. They have gotten conflict resolution skills. They have developed different sets of values and different skills that will help them then as they go on. Many have already transitioned into jobs and therefore their own food and shelter, which is exactly the goal that we would have for everybody. So, in absentia, I really want to thank Dave Kober for the work that he has done with that organization. And I want to thank especially also tonight Greg Vell. Would you mind coming up? I'm going to give you three sentences, you said. Greg Vell has been the one in charge of the food part of our program here at Pioneer for over 4 years now. He manages to get up. Someone down there at 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock on Saturdays to get the breakfast after he's fixed the memorial meal on Friday night. And he's done that time after time after time, and is in charge of the big volunteers. So give him an opportunity to say a few words.
Well, thank you. I'll tell you, this is the richest experience I've ever had working with Reverend Bell and Dave.
That giving tree is for families that are affected. affected by HIV. But if you take an organ off of that to buy a gift for a child of such a family, that has to be back by Monday morning. So if you're going to do that, keep in mind that you've got less than $48 to get that done. Not that I'm trying to stop you or anything. Before I go, I would like to especially give thanks to the wonderful volunteers, all of these people that you have heard giving their gifts of music, sharing the gifts of music, the choir and the orchestra are giving it free from their own spirit.